So I needed to get some more storage space for my tools, and I decided to go with a Harbor Freight 5-drawer mechanics cart. I've read such great reviews and seen the videos on this. I just don't think you can go wrong at this price point with what you get. 15,000 cubic inches of storage and 700 pounds total weight capacity. What I've read and what I've heard is that the people who've used these carts have just really enjoyed them and have had great use out of them. So I like the lime green, that's why I went with this. My job this morning is to set this up and get it assembled. I'm just going to lift up the whole top of the box like this. Careful with this lid because it doesn't have the struts installed yet, so it will just flop back if you let it go. In the top here of the box we have the struts as well as the instructions. And in the front here, taped, are the keys. And we have four sets of keys. This is where they have the instructions, and it lays it all out. But I think it's best to watch a YouTube video or two before you start doing this. It might just save you some hassles down the road. So now that you have your box lifted off the base, you can open up the bottom drawer. You have to just lift the top so you have access. This rolls out, and here you have the box with the casters, as well as your side tray, and you have the reinforcements for your top corners. Now as we open this box up, we find our casters, two of them swivel, two of them are fixed, and we find two bags of nuts and bolts. This one has the washers in there, as well as bolt, carriage bolts, and the nuts with the nylon inside, the nylocks. This bag is for the casters only, and this bag doesn't have the flat washers, and the carriage bolts are slightly longer, and these are for everything else that you're going to do on your box. So just know that that one is for the casters only, and this one is for the rest of the box. So the nuts are all the same size being used. It's all either a half inch or a 13 millimeter, and I would say you could use a flex ratcheting wrench or have a socket ready, and that should be all that you need to put this together. Now I'm putting on the struts just to keep the top open. Just note the orientation with the black part on the top here, and you put the nuts in by hand just to keep it in place. If using the nylock nuts that you get with the packet with the casters, and you are going to need a 12 millimeter to keep it steady on the inside, and then the 13 or the half inch to fasten it on the outside. So now we have to test to see if our top closes properly, and it does, and it opens right up again. Excellent. Now it's time to fix your casters to your cart, and what you want to keep in mind is to have your fixed casters on one end and your swivel casters on the other end. The swivel casters will be on the end where your handle will be at the end of the day, whichever side you want that on your cart. Now these casters are pretty heavy, they're heavy duty as well, they spin very freely, which is kind of nice. And then of course they have these grease nipples over here, so you could re-grease them when you need to. They come pre-greased, so you don't need to do it right away, but once the grease is worn out, you know, you can refill that, which is great. Now you need to peel back the liner that you have inside, and it exposes all the holes that you need for the casters. One thing I've discovered now putting on the first two casters is that these holes are supposed to lock up your carriage bolts, and there's a bit of powder coating there in the way. So what's helpful is to place it in the way it's going to be. Just give it a quick tap with a hammer so it's seated properly, and it's going to help you so that it doesn't spin around when you put on the nuts from the other side. Of course, these bolts are going to go through from the underside, and the nuts and the washers come from the side. Now you just get all your holes lined up. Put your carriage bolt in from the bottom. Make sure it's seated properly there. And then your nylock nut goes from the top. Keep your thumb underneath. And there you go. So if you're not using an impact, it's the same procedure. Get your bolt seated from down under. And then just get your nut on with your ratchet. Now that you have the base of your cart done, it's time to put on the four posts. You now, for the rest of the cart, you're going to be using these short carriage bolts and the flanged nuts that you find in the other little bag. Now you want to get the correct orientation for your four posts on the corners. And what you need to do is look at the hole in the middle there and the ones on the end, and you'll see that the distance between the middle and the one end is shorter than the distance between the middle and the other end. The short end is going to be the bottom. It's going to stand up like that, and it's going to be affixed to the outside of the cart. And what you want to do first is just to put in the nuts and the bolts by hand and not tighten them down completely until you've got the box mounted on the top. Otherwise it might be a struggle. Now a helpful tip is to put the brakes on before you start putting this on so the cart doesn't roll around. The post comes on the outside like we said, and the carriage bolt is going to go through from the side right in. Just pin them on by hand and you'll be ready for the next step. Now that you have the four posts done, it's time for the cross members, and you're going to do the front and the back first. The orientation is with the lip pointing inwards. Now as you put these shorter cross sections in, it's time to decide which side your tray is going to be. Now I want my tray to be on this side because this is where I have my swivel casters, and it's this side that my handle will be. I don't want anything sticking out on the other side of the cart, so it's I have more space to park it. Now when you put these in, they'll slide in like this, and the lip will be over the lip of the front and the back sections. Now the tray gets mounted with the same nuts and bolts you've been using all around. The bolt goes through from the outside, and once again just hand tighten it inside. You might have to lift the post a tad just to get the holes to line up, but once you've done that, it's going to be all systems go. Now we get to the time when the box has to be placed inside the post. To do that, I'm going to open up the top so that I can take out these drawers. And I'm going to remove all of these drawers just to lighten my box. On the side here, you'll see a little black tab. You push this down. And then on the opposite side will be a black tab which will be pushed up at the same time, and then you can just pull the drawer right out. And out it comes. Okay, so now you want to take your box and you want to drop it in between the four posts. And this is where you're going to be so glad that you didn't tighten those posts too severely, because as you drop the box, you might want to move them slightly just to accommodate the box. Now this box is fairly heavy, so I don't recommend doing this by yourself, unless like me, you take out the drawers and then you can do it by yourself. Before you do that, it's a good idea just to lock the top so that nothing flies open while you're working with that. And once you've got this in place, you can open it up again. And now it's time to put in the support struts inside. Now you have four of these little supports that go in the four corners, and as you can see, you just put the carriage bolt from the outside and just put the nuts on the inside, the flange nuts, and you just tighten them up once again. Don't go to town on these now, because you can always snug them up a bit later. This is one of the instances where you'll be so happy if you've just hand tightened everything else, because you'll be able to line up these holes much more easily. As you're putting the inserts into support from the inside, it's also the time you're going to have to decide where to put your handle for your cart. Now, as you assemble the handle, the same thing, the carriage bolt goes from the outside and the nuts on the inside. This cart is really very consistent with the way that you set this up, and once you get started, you'll know what to do. Now you have the fun job of starting at the bottom and going through the cart and tightening all the nuts and bolts that you have from the bottom right through to the top. Now it's time just to bolt on the handle for the lid here, and this is pretty straightforward with a Phillips screw. You want to line up this channel over here with the sliders over there. Once you've got them lined up, you just push it in all the way, and now it's going to be fine. There you go. So at the end of this build, I have some spare parts that must have given me some extra, and I'll just keep these in case I need them. Now that the cart is finished, you can see what it looks like. Beautiful racing green. And then these, of course, just slide in and out. Ready for tools, ready for action. I think I'm going to really enjoy this cart. I think this is a solid cart at a solid price, giving you solid value, and I don't think you can go wrong with this.